If there is heaven, I know what heaven is like. There is the rock to be climbed, the cone that springs from the plain. That first rise in the great stair is terrible. The steepness drags on the feet, sucks at the breath. At the first halt, the plain has already receded. Buildings have shrunk. Gardens and roads are flat patterns. Sounds are remote.
We turn inwards. Cliffs on our left. The way is rough. The stones are painful for walking. There is no gentleness. Even the water is violent and hurls itself downhill, staining the rocks. There is the little dark church, old and full of strange tales and memories of the past, striving, ardent, and bitter. On the right are the ruins of houses, close to the edge, staring with empty eyes down the drop of the cliff, or crumbling and moving stone by stone down the terrible slope. All these we must pass as we climb and leave them behind us. As we leave ruined hopes and the wastage of time, we go up over stones and the track becomes dimmer, but at last we are there. Even the fortress, last ruin of pride, stripped and bleached like the skull of a bird of prey found on the mountain, even this is behind us. We walk out onto grassland, short grass and sparse, few flowers, sharp and sweet breezes.
It is a place never seen before, but wholly familiar. Perhaps in some dream, or some cave in the mind were foreshadowed the light, the silence, and the great blue deep of air.